Greetings everyone, and today I'm gonna show you another place in Kathmandu, in Nepal. I visited Nepal long time ago, but I still have a lot of material, a lot of video to share with you. Pashupatinath, that's the name of the temple I'm gonna show you. It's in the center of Kathmandu. Really, it's really crowded there, and a lot of different exotic stuff in there, but we are curious in different issues. I mean, street sellers is not important. The most important thing for me is how they use this temple, not today, but how it was supposed to be used before mud flood. Today they use to burn people. Today is a place of worship. Simply nothing else, just to pray and so on and burn people. But what is more important, how this all was done and how this all worked before. So let's take a look how they're using it today, but it's not so important. And then I will try to explain you, share my vision and some thoughts about how all those devices, all these places and buildings were used in the past. For me, it's definitely technical, antiquitech, technical equipment of our ancient past before invasion. So let's start my personal shootings. And let's start with the video of the lowest row of so-called transformator devices. That's how I call it. It's perfect masonry. It's made of black stone, granite or basalt. And I have no idea how it was carved, done 200 years ago officially, without electricity, without diamond tools, discs, drills, and so on. I mean, the official story about copper chisels, it's bullshit. I'm not buying it, definitely. Look how beautiful it is. And it definitely was carved somehow by using technology of softening stones. And those lingams, they are everywhere, in each and every building. And this is definitely was made for sound. Those domes, I will show you a bit later how it was built. They hide it. They try to hide the domes. And those niches, they are all to make rotation of, you know, energy. It's a resonator. It's all was done for sounds, to create vibrations of sound and frequencies. Look how beautiful it is. It's like mandala. If maybe you didn't see, but it's like a dome to make this whirlpool, vortex of energies going around. And those niches were emitting some energy waves going around to make in a circle, and some coil was there, I think, on lingam. It's definitely a technical device. And it's waveguided going there for another place, for another device. And it also was resonating with all other buildings, and wave was coming throughout, energy wave was coming throughout all those buildings. Huge amount, line. It's all line of resonators directing energies to one place in the center, and lingam was redirecting energies somehow out. And outer waveguides were also directing somehow. And it's like everywhere near, just by the river, near the water. And it's also kind of waveguide, a really huge waveguide down there between all those temples. It's not coincidence. There is a technical device, definitely. It's like a microchip again. Now we are making microchip, but this is huge. Plato, I don't know how to say, microchip, high frequency device. It's a good question. Many people, like my friend, want to sleep there. I really also wanted to sleep there because of huge amount of energy, high vibrational energies, and people want to have rest there. Many people sleep there, and I also wanted to sleep. I'm saying again, because of very dense energy there in that place. And as you see on the right, also there were some resonators. I will show you a bit later. Now let's take a look. I visited almost all such small buildings, like boutique, like for dogs, you know, dog house, I would call it. And they all are the same. The same niches, symmetrical. Is it coincidence? I don't think so. So, let's continue. Beautiful carving. It was built differently in the line, you know. It's not unique. And those resonators in the wall also to direct energies there to those buildings. Here we see the same situation. Resonators sending energies and vibrations of the rock to here, to direct energy here. And then this further line also resonates and redirect energy as waveguide to another place, to the center. I will try to find this center, if it's still there. Some spare parts also outside. And again, there is no chance for all this to be done manually using handwork. It's not handmade. It's a waveguide. Some strange things, but it's a round shape waveguide. And all this is a huge complex of free energy buildings to make not only energy and vibrations, but to serve for something bigger than only place of praying, worshiping, and so on. Of course, all technologies are lost. And today, it's, you know, how to say, deception, like an empty place. Cargo cult. Monkeys and people also like monkeys walking around without any clue of what is it and what for. And I feel shame, sad. My sadness is very on very high level. And a lot of Russian people there, like those ladies. I met them previously in the hotel. This my friend also, my neighbor. He's in adjacent room with mine. So it's strange, weird, but really a lot of Russians were there. I was surprised. Strange. And let's try to climb up. Go up using the stairs. But here we see the same. The same. It's not only for worship. It's, you know, like every car looks like all other cars. The same wheels, the same engine, doors, and so on. And all those free energy generators look the same because technology is the same. Stones. Nobody knows where they took it from. Technology. Purpose, design. Design is absolutely the same, like design of one car copies design of any other car, no matter what color we use to paint and what kind of other material and so on. Still, some principles are the same. The same idea, the same design, the same purpose to drive. Here, I see the same. In all temples all over the world, I see the same design, the same principles, the same dome to make standing waves, the same waveguides, just different level of technology, different technical principles we are not allowed to use today. The same purpose of all bells without anything inside, because it's not for heating. Yeah, nice dog. really.
Не, нету ничего.
I couldn't feed it.
Кем ты была?
But anyway.
Или был.
Very nice.
Да, привет.
Spirit in this inside. Nice soul inside this
вот,
dog.
Нету.
There is nothing inside. And it looks like artificial. Originally, it was nothing inside because it's not for mechanical hitting, beating with this so-called bell. It's like a horn antenna to my extending wave below there. It's like a resonator also. And it was designed to increase vibrations when it wasn't enough. It's like horn antenna, but also adding vibrations to create energy. Because it rings even without any hitting, any mechanical. Nothing originally was applied there. Actually, as I said, all was about vibrations and standing waves. So please try to think what technologies were used, because today we have no idea about supreme, higher, better technologies we had in the past. We are not allowed to. Our enemy doesn't want us to be free, healthy, and inspired, full of energy. So everything now is perverted and distorted. We live in deception. And I feel really sad when I touch the devices of our previous civilization. It's definitely technical. Just hear the sound. But guys, I insist, originally there was no bell clapper inside. And with the same design like any Russian church, waveguides on below, one big dome and maybe at least four, sometimes it's eight smaller domes for resonating to keep the frequency. Russian churches, small churches, especially small ones, look absolutely the same design, the same principles. A few waves, one dome going to second. Then to keep frequency, to tune frequency, we have smaller domes and the same design is everywhere. Here also, no bell clapper. We call it tone, bell tone, forever. Here is the place for another dome, for another bell. And here we see some spare parts. It definitely looks like spare parts. They're made of different material, different kind of stone. Nobody knows where to take it, where it's taken from. Looks like really artificial. And here is the same, like mandala. It's like mandala, but it's horn antenna. Huge horn antenna to direct energy. Energy and frequencies, vibrations, direct to the bottom. And here symmetrically we see niches like swastika to redirect energies, make them go around, make a whirlpool. It's like snake going around. It symbolically means energies, and then it redirects energy out. And here we see again waveguide. And here also resonators, and energy goes out. It's also round waveguide, making vibrations and sending energies, infra vibrations, to the churches. But everywhere the same. I am a bit tired of walking there. The same design, the same technology, everywhere. There are hundreds of them. Maybe used to be thousands. But they all are the same, really. So let's continue on going up. And we see steps even on side. On sides of this step stairs, we see steps with the same resonators. like corrugated way of
like in pyramid in South America, Peru, so on. Corrugated, corrugated, whatever, corrugated waveguide. It's a great energy complex. Это огромный энергокомплекс. Ага. Акустический, но ничего не напоминает.
This is like some kind of acoustic device.
That looks similar. It looks like kind of musical instrument, like камертон. Vibration from the center. Resonate going there. And here they cut it, they stop it, catch it and collect it. The same like wells. Step wells, but it's not step wells, it's not for water. It's for vibration and energies. It's sending out. It's not for well, it's not for water. It's like step well. To get some harvest some energies. Some vibrations and get energy, catch it by this and send it. Is this for stopping? Это вот чтобы остановить?
Is this to stop energy? Or it was added later? What do you think, guys? And again, another 150, I don't know what number of bell. The same. No bell clapper inside. Originally, it was for something else. It was not for hanging. It was not designed for hanging, it was not designed to have any clapper inside. Bell clapper was not there originally. Because those bells, these bells, not for make noise by mechanical applying, mechanical deformation and so on. It must not be beaded. And which is the shape of waveguide? Very interesting also for me, because I could see this fork, three-headed fork in Greece, in Russia, in many other places. I think it was to direct energy up, flow of energy. What for? What we were creating, kind of power shields or what? I have no idea, I want to know. But here we have the same situation. Again, strange shape of bell. Really strange shape. And it's a symbol of Vajra there. So the symbol of making energy in these bells and in Vajra is the same. I see dragon. I see six-pointed star. It's like David star, but it's not David. It's nothing to do with Jews or any religion. It's not for religion. It's not even symbol, it was device, shape of resonator. And we see some kind of hive. It's also nice, also symbolic. And it's definitely mud-flooded building. Again, again and again. Pineal gland, pine cones, everywhere, on most of the bells. It's also for resonating and for directing energies. There are many shapes of different resonators, but watch this again. The same principle like in fascists. Well, I think it's time to end our short trip for today. It's enough because they all are the same, but I will continue this trip. I will continue making video about Nepal. At least one more, because there is something to share with you. So thank you for your attention. Enough for today. Please write in comments what do you think and why Nepal has so many ancient pre-flood technologies and buildings survived, left there. And I will go to Hiramant. I mean, he will, to the guy who will read my palm and tell me everything about me. That's another story.